Hey guys, it's Yusuf with the Collectiv crew, and in case you missed it, Microsoft hosted their annual Microsoft Business Application Summit this past week, and with it, as always, it was filled with so many great announcements and features that are coming to the Microsoft suite of applications and tools, and so I thought I'd share my top five favorite announcements from this past event. Here we go. So first off, those of you who have been building Power Apps through Microsoft Teams, using the Microsoft Teams Dataverse, there are already five amazing templates you can use, but now it was just announced that there'll be five new templates coming before the summer. So two of them haven't been announced exactly what they're gonna be, but one will be a Profile Plus, which is essentially, if you ever use Delve, it's kind of like that, but it has way more features and it'll be right built into Microsoft Teams. Then there's a Discussions and a Boards, Power Apps, templates that are also being added. And so by the summer, we'll have five templates added in there to help you get started and streamline common business processes and solutions and ways to just collaborate and engage with employees. And so it's super exciting. If you haven't gotten into building Power Apps for Microsoft Teams, now's the time. And like I said, there's already five templates in there to get you started. And now there's gonna be five more before the summer hits. Next, for those who've used model-driven apps, and you've ever wanted to incorporate Canvas apps, you've always had to do a little bit of a PCF, a component control to have those added in. And there's different little ways to embed it. But now a new model-driven app designer is going to be released that will allow you to easily add a custom page for Power Apps Canvas app so that it's now in your model-driven app easily. And while you work through model-driven apps, you'll now be able to see what they look like as you build them. And so this is just a huge step for model-driven app building, as well as a way to bring both model-driven apps and Canvas apps together. Also, it was announced that in 2022, we'll be seeing a whole new Power Apps Studio Designer that will allow you to easily create both Canvas and model-driven apps all in one designer, one application and platform instead of two separate ones. So something to look forward to, and it's planned to be in the first release wave of 2022. Next up is Power BI. One of the announcements that I'm definitely looking forward to is the new automated insights. So the automated insights combine all the AI functionality you have in Power BI, ranging from anomaly detection to smart narratives and the decomposition tree into a single end-to-end experience catered to your needs. AI is huge, and the fact that we're getting these new enhancements with AI into Power BI, Power Apps, Power Automate, is huge. And now with Power BI, we could really get into these great data insights. And now on top of that, add the AI functionality. And so a lot to come from there. And that's definitely a feature to look out for. The next great feature announced for Power BI is going to be goals tracking. Now, most organizations have struggled with goal tracking just because it's a combination of, let's say, a database you're managing for the goal tracking and then your actual business data, which that doesn't sync up or align with one another, and usually you're doing a bunch of manual updates to keep them synced together. Now with this new feature, you'll be able to have it all built in. So now teams can easily curate business matrices that matter most and aggregate them into a unified view. From there, your team can go ahead and measure the progress from the goal tracking functionality, and they can share it with teams. They can do a deep dive into the data to see if something needs more further analysis because of the indicators that they're viewing. Users can easily monitor the health of their business, bringing data across multiple Power BI workspaces and create gorgeous scorecards to drive impact. This is gonna be huge as well. I mean, all these announcements are huge, but this is definitely, goal tracking is something I know that a lot of companies struggle with in a way that it's hard to get combined. And so now this is gonna save a lot of time and bring a lot more new insights into Power BI for your goal tracking needs. And there you have it, my five favorite announcements, but those were just five, and there were so many more that were announced. So definitely check out the Microsoft website to get that full list of features and announcements made at the summit event. And as always, make sure to follow the Collectiv crew and subscribe to YouTube so that you can stay on top of all the latest tips and tricks and announcements for all things related to Microsoft and the tools and platforms. Again, I'm Yusuf with the Collectiv crew, and I'll chat with all you guys later. Bye.